little half-sister, AFREEN Fatima. She did her, completed her master's in computer applications, and she completed Quran Tafsir courses in English and Urdu from Al Huda Online Institute. She studied Quran word to word, meaning Tafsir, Hadith, and different Islamic subjects. She is currently teaching Quran Tafsir online and live in different masajids. She has been doing this for the last 6 years.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Jazakallah khair, Sonia. Jazakallah khair to all the girls. MashaAllah, you did great job. Amira, Sonia, Sania, MashaAllah. Because I always appreciate teens, you know. They are the one who gonna take future. So please, more and more teens, I need it. And we are doing for the sake of Allah. And we should gather together so that we can achieve the, you know, rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, let's start with the dua. A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. Wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilma. Allahumma faqina fid din. Ameen. So today's topic is welcome Ramadan. As we know, only few days left, inshallah, we're going to start Ramadan. So how are we going to welcome it? So everybody talks about it and they say we have to do it with the khushu. And this is a guest who is coming to our home and we have to welcome the guest. So I'm going to see the ayahs of Surah Al-Anfal. We have seen the following ayahs in translation of Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 183. Inshallah, we're going to continue that later. But right now, I want to have that khushu. First of all, we gather here. All the angels are here who are witnessing all of us. So have that faith, have that rahmah, you know, no matter how much we are, what matters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in, you know, there's a hadith in which it says Allah don't see your, you know, what you have wealth, what, how your face is, but it will acknowledge your good deeds, isn't it? So for achieving the good deeds, what is the way we should go? We should go the way what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us through the Quran and through the Sunnah. What is the Sunnah? That is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. So let's start with Surah Al-Anfal. In ayah number 2, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innamal mu'minuna allazina iza zukirallahu wajilat qulubuhum. You know, certainly the believers are those who hearts are filled with awe. And what, how are they? Iza zukirallaha wajilat qulubuhum. You know, when ayahs was reciting right now, how our hearts were. Wajilat qulubuhum. Our hearts are filled with awe of Allah and love of Allah. Mu'min is always in two state. One in the hope, the other in the fear. Hope of Jannah and hope of mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to forgive us. And, you know, have the, you know, fear of the Jahannam. These are the only two things. And here it says, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ. When ayats was reciting right now, how was? زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. Our iman was increasing. Isn't it? The ayahs were so nice and it was so soothing to our ears. You know, who recites so well and who listens to the different Qur'ans, you know, they know what is the qira'at of the Qur'an, how the recitation should be, how the good recitation. So it will increase. Zadathum imana. Wa imana wa ala rabbihim yatawakkalun. It's not only iman is increasing, what else? Our tawakkul. You know, you complete trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here we learn a lesson from this. Whenever you have grief or sorrow, how our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do, you know, do the salah, nawafil, and also reciting the Quran. So here, when Quran is recited, it will increase your iman. So gradually the other things will go off. Here, the next ayah, it says, Allazina yuqimuna salata. Those who establish salat wa mimma razaqnahum yunfikun, and they spend. So here we have seen this ayah, it reminds of Surah Al-Baqarah, isn't it? We have seen the qualities of muflihun, and in that we have seen who are the muflihun. They spend, right? They establish salah, the how it should be. It should be on the time, and they do extra nawafil, and they do the all the prerequisite of the salah, and also they spend mimma razaqnahum yunfikhun. So spending, it's just only money? No. This is the spending. Right now you are here. Allah is witnessing. Angels are witnessing. Mimma razaqnahum yunfikhun. You all are, Allah is acknowledging you. You are spending your time. You are spending your energy here. So Allah will witness that, you know. So this is mimma razaqnahum yunfikhun. Ulaika Allah. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ulaika humul mu'minuna haqqa. These are the believers. Lahum darajatun inda rabbihim wa maghfiratun wa rizqun kareem. What two things we are getting? We are getting, you know, maghfira. We all want maghfira, isn't it? What is maghfira? It's from ghafara. We want the maghfira from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we talk about Ramadan, we say, oh, it's a month of mercy. It's a month of ghafara. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins, isn't it? We keep asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please forgive our sins. And what else, you know, rizqun kareem. Isn't it? We are asking for the provision. Allah, give us more provision. And here Allah is saying honored provision. Kareem. So subhanallah, Kareem. And here they are on the haq and they have darajat. Have you seen the darajat, the levels? This I can explain you. When you go on the business class or the first class, have you ever noticed? We love to go on that. So darajat, one level is different to the another. How the darajat will be? So the jannat have so many darajat. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, whenever you want jannah, like ask, Allahumma inni asaluka jannatul firdaus. Ask for the firdaus. So here, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like here, is saying, you know, how these are the prerequisite. Then only we can be in the quality of the muflihun. We have seen in the Surah Al-Baqarah who are muflihun. So let's see further, like just now we girls has recited the ayahs and seen the translation. So let's see the detail of it. This is the place where Surah Al-Baqarah from ayah number 183 onwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining about Ramadan. It's a month. And you know, one after another, it explains so nicely. If you just see the translation, you could understand it, mashallah. But not only this ayah, we're going to see more inshallah. So here, ya ayyuhallazina amanu kutiba alaykum siyam. So O you who believe, allazina amanu kutiba is from kataba, it's like, you know, ordained, made compulsory. Kitab is written, is used for the writing, but it's not for writing here. You know, those who know a little bit Arabic or they understand it, they know the literal and the linguistic meaning of the Quran. So here it says it is made mandatory, compulsory, and that alaykum siyamu kama kutiba alal lazina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. So if you draw a flow chart, what is the end result for it? Tattaqun, they will get taqwa. So girls, are you following it? Alhamdulillah, you are here. So we are getting taqwa. That's the thing we want to achieve. So this is the key thing, 183 ayah. You know, Allah is saying one-to-one. You know how I am talking to everyone? But Allah is saying, you know, one is talking to another. I am talking to you and you are listening to me. It's like that. Because Allah is saying, ya ayyuhal lazina amanu. Don't we believe? We are the believers, isn't it? Allah is honoring us. Oh, my believers. So we are honored. And here we have to do the fasting. And what else? Ayyaman ma'dudat, only few days, few number days. You know, you have to do just 29 or 30 days. And then ayyaman ma'dudat, faman kana minkum faridan aw ala safarin. Allah is giving exception now. Okay, what if, you know, you are marid, you are sick, aw ala safarin, or if you are on journey, what you can do? Ayyaman ukhar, you know, you can do it later on, isn't it? Sometimes we are on journey, we are sick in sense, sometimes we are in period. Are we doing it later? Isn't it? We are doing it later. And then, الَّذِينَ يُتِيخُونَ فِدْيَةٌ تَعَامَ الْمِسْكِينَ. If you can't do that, then give the money to تَعَامَ الْمِسْكِينَ. But when we talk about تَعَامَ الْمِسْكِينَ, giving the food to miskin, how much you're going to give? Give good food, you know. And if you can't make the food, you can spend the money, at least two time food. Are we eating just one time? No, right? We are eating at least two to three times. So give food or the money. And then, but whoever can voluntarily do it, that's khair for you. And وَأَن تَصُومُوا خَيْرًا لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If you know. But some Mufassir said this was abrogated. And here in the next ayah, شَهْرُ رَمْدَانَ الَّذِي. And this is the ayah which talks about how Quran was sent down. But you must be thinking, Quran was sent in 23 years, isn't it? We are talking, Wahi came in 23 years, and that's how Quran revealed. But here, the main copy, which is in the Lohe Mahfuz, is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The original copy we are talking about. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent that. So talking about Shahru Ramzan. It is the month of Ramadan in which this is Quran is sent. And what else it has? Hudan. It is a hidayah. When we see hudan, it has fathatain. So it is nakira. What kind of huda? It is irshad and tawfiq. Both the hidayah. You know, when you get the tawfiq, like, you know, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah will guide you, isn't it? It's like, you know, you want to go somewhere. So you want to go somewhere, you're saying, oh, I want to go and I'm going to go there. No, you're going to put that address in GPS, right? First you have tawfiq and you put that. And then you took that rushd, isn't it? You went on that path. So this is tawfiq and irshad. So Allah is guiding you, hudan. And then linnas wa bayinat. And notice that it is for linnas. It's not for ya ayyuhal lazina amanu. It's for linnas, for the people. And this is bayinat. Clear, it's clear cut. Have you seen, like, in the starting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying introduction, la raiba fihi hudal lil muttaqin. There is no doubt, don't even think about it. You know, every preface we see the book and we see the author says, you know, I did the mistake, please forgive me for that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's khaliq, malik, mudabbir, no doubt. So here, bayinat, clear proofs. Min al huda wal furqan. This is not only huda, it's a guidance, it's also furqan. What is furqan? Furqan is the thing which differentiates between good and bad, haq and batil, right and wrong. That's what furqan is. Faman shahida minkum. Whoever witness, you know, whoever is alive, whoever is good, shahira fal yasumhu, wan kana marida. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are sick, if you are on journey, then again you have to do it later. And but Allah has made easy for you, it's not difficult. And after that, wala tukmilu, if you complete, after completing that, what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying? Wala tukabbiru. Proclaim the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have you seen, like, you know, after completing 29 or 30 siyam, psalm, then we proclaim Allahu Akbar Kabira walhamd. We are proclaiming the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is great. So Allah is saying, after completing, proclaim the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the rahmah of Allah we completed, right? Otherwise we can't. It's really hard for us. Then Allahu la ma hadakum. This is my guidance. Allah is saying, this is my guidance. And wala allakum tashkurun, so that you will be thankful. So here clear cut ahkamat is given. So be thankful. Later on ayahs we're going to see, inshallah, when I'm going to refer those ayahs. Because this is the month of dua. We're going to see those ayahs. So here we will see, this is the month of Ramadan where the shaitan are closed. They are chained, isn't it? All the shaitans are chained. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when Ramadan comes, the door of the heavens are open and door of the hell are closed. And shaitan is in chain. And here, when you welcome the Ramadan, how are we going to welcome it? Like, you know, you go and see the moon. Oh, moon is sighting. Then what you do? The next thing, you recite the dua. Isn't it? We recite the dua. and Allahumma ahillahu alayna bil yumni wal imani was salamati wal islami rabbi wa rabbukallah. So here the beautiful dua, what we are saying, oh Allah, let this moon month pass over us with blessing, iman and safety. Isn't it? We all need safety. We have seen previously in months how it was. Yeah, safety is so important to us, isn't it? And in the state of Islam. And not only that, Moon is saying, your Lord and my Lord is same. Subhanallah, Moon is saying that, witnessing that. This is in Tirmidhi. And there is one more dua. Allahu Akbar, Allahumma ahillahu alayna bil amni wal imani wa salamati wal islami wa tawfiqi lima tuhibbi wa tarda rabbuka rabbuna wa rabbukallah. Same thing, only little bit difference here. And here, when we say Ramadan, it's the month of Rahma and Barakah. Lot of Rahmah is there, lot of Barakah is there. So here, Ramadan, when we say, Iza kana Ramadanu, Futihat Abwabu Rahmah. Like, you know, doors of the Rahmah is open. This is in Sahih Muslim. And here, as I mentioned before, and there is a hadith, Ramadan has come to you a blessed month. This is in Musnad Ahmad. Allah has obligatory upon you is fasting. In it, the gates of heaven are open, gates of the hell are closed, and evil devils are chained. So this is the Rahmah. But you must be wondering, you know, even though shaitan are chained, still we get angry, we get upset. What is that? Our nafs, our oneself. So you have to control ourselves because it's a training time. It's training time for 29 to 30 days. But you know, some of us are in 30s, 40s, and we must be thinking, oh, we have been fasting from maybe we started 7 or 8 years. So still we are fasting from 20, 25 years, isn't it? So we are trained. No, every year we need that reminder, isn't it? Shaitan is always there to whisper and all the negative thing. This is like, you know, complete cleansing. You know, when you go to the doctor, it says, you know, drink lot of water. It's going to clean your, you know, the whole system, isn't it? It will detox your body. It's a best thing to detox. But you know, if you ask the people, even non-Muslim, they say you have to have the fast to detox your body. But Allah is saying, that's the hukum of Allah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us this is the way. So don't think, you know, scientifically or biologically we're going to have these benefits. First, you know, intention is for the sake of Allah. Then all the health benefits. Don't think, oh, I'm going to be skinny. You will never be skinny. If you are just thinking that I'm going to fast and be skinny, you can't. Your intention should be to please Allah. Your intention should be, Allah will give me the reward for this. So inshallah, that way you can improve. And here in Ramadan, you should hasten to all the good things. Just look around. Girls or us, everyone, I'm talking especially to girls because our girls are going to school and college. It's really difficult for them. But I see in a different manner. Look at the positive side. Now you're going school or college, you're busy. And you have the best time to do dawah, isn't it? You're showing everyone, even though I'm fasting, nothing can affect me. If they are saying bad word or four letter word, doesn't matter. Move from there. I'm fasting. I'm not going to listen to this kind of thing, you know. Literally, those words feel like, you know, our ears are melting. Really, you know, sometimes when I pass by and some teens, they talk about such bad things. Auzubillah, I says, what happened to them? Why they are talking in such a manner? We have to control ourselves. And then there are a few duas we can do. Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum bi rahmatika astaghees asli li shani kullahu la takilni ila nafsi tarfatain. I'm just giving an example. There are a few more duas you can recite it. And not only this, it's a month of Siyam. Why we are doing it? We have seen already the ayahs which says why we should fast. But you know, fasting is a means of entry in the paradise. It's a mean to entry into the paradise. That's the reason we are fasting. And you know, only Allah knows, we know. We can hide and drink water, but we never do that. We never ever do that. Even a Muslim who has lesser or least iman, they will never do that. I have a good feeling about everyone. They will never ever do that. Even though they don't do salah the whole year, but still they fast. Because they want that rahmah. They want that 100% marks. They want Laylatul Qadr, isn't it? And there is a special door in paradise which is called Babur Rayyan. Only people who are eligible, who are fasting. We want that eligibility, isn't it? We want to enter through Babur Rayyan. So, inshallah, we all will try our best to enter through this door. And Allah will give reward for fasting. You know, for everything, Allah is giving and saying, oh, for this, you're going to get this much reward. But fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter says, it's like a surprise for us. Allah will reward us. We don't know how much it is. So there's a hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Every good deed of the son of Adam is for him, except for fasting. It is for me, and I shall reward the fasting person. This is in Sahih al-Bukhari. So we have to achieve that. And here, it is a great, good deeds receive a reward from 10 to 700 times. But how we know? It's an ayah in the Surah al-Baqarah. 10 to 700 times spikes how it's going to divide. And the next thing, the odor of the mouth of the person, you know. When you fast, you might have noticed, even though you did miswak or you did, brush, still you feel that you have odor. Because our stomach is very empty. Because of that, you feel that. But the odor of the mouth of the fasting person has been appreciated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if it's a musk. Okay, but it doesn't mean that you're going to be meeting the people and behaving in such a manner and you are going close and they feel bad. It's not so. Use the miswak, or the best thing we can do, right? Some ulama says we can use toothpaste and brush, but what if it goes here? I don't want to take any risk. Even if you are so careful, that's okay. But if you are not, if it goes, you can use plain brush, take out the new one and use that. And after that, you could feel it, there will be no breathe or anything, but no bad breath or anything. But it's okay. Allah knows. We can't, just don't go so close to them, if we don't want to trouble them. And fasting is a shield. Have you seen when they go to war, how the shield will be? Or when we are in the rainy season, how we are covering ourselves? It's a shield. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fasting is a shield from hellfire, like the shield of one of you in the battle. This is in Sunan Ibn Majah. And fasting is a protection from hellfire. So no slaves fast one day in the way of Allah without Allah putting his face 70 years journey away from the fire. 70 years away. On the account of that day, this is in Sahih Muslim. And Siyam means, completely stopping something. And here, Sama Yasumu, we are stopping from eating, drinking, and also the relationship. We are stopping ourselves. But, here, there are a few things I want to tell. There are three levels of fasting. Here, Ibn al-Jawziya, he said three ways. First is the ordinary fasting, to abstain from eating and physical desires and all those things. The second is the special fasting to protect the eyes, your tongues, limbs, and all other organs of the body from the sin. This is the second one. Unique fasting to rid the heart of every useless and baseless things. Anything, you want to distant yourself and your heart is filled with the awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best thing we can do, combining all these three, so we're going to abstain from all this thing, we're going to remind ourselves. If somebody is saying bad, you're going to remind, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, do a lot of durood. You're going to remind yourself. That way, our tongue will be moist with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the scholar was saying, I really like that thing. When we fast, we don't feel like thirst. Really. And for me, I'm really thirsty, most of the time. And right now also. So here, when you are fasting, you don't feel like you are thirsty. Why is it so? Because you are doing zikr. Zikr makes your tongue so moist. Even I notice myself, even though when we are in period, we are not fasting, but still we don't feel like eating or drinking, isn't it? We are doing like complete zikr, and normally we don't remind ourselves, but when in the month of Ramadan, no, at least I should do zikr, because I am not reciting Quran, I am not doing psalm, I am not doing salah, you know, subhanallah. And sometimes we come here in the Taraweeh, oh, I want to listen to the Qari, you know, how he recites it, subhanallah. So here, next thing we're going to learn, what is Shahrul Iftar, you know, how the fasting we break. So at the time of breaking the fast, you know, you should make a lot of dua. Allah will listen to you. So please take out some time, you know, if you want to make pakora or anything, just make it before, keep it ready. Don't do it till last time. If you're doing it, just keep on do the zikr and keep the things handy, you know, like, you know, do dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, there's a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah won't listen to the person who's have a heedless heart. We want to, you know, make dua with a heedless heart? No. We want to make a dua list. Right now, make a dua list. All the girls, especially, you have a lot of things in your mind, isn't it? Make a list. You want to have this. Come on, go for it. There's a sale going on. Ramadan is coming. What you are waiting for? Go ahead. And here, suhoor, you know, for a believer, there are blessing in suhoor. It's a sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's a blessing. And, you know, there is farhatan. There is two happiness for the person who is fasting. One is when you break the fast, don't you feel that when you put the tamara, like, you know, when you put the date in your mouth, you feel so nice, alhamdulillah. And that time you realize, when you watch the documentaries about the people, those who don't have food, actually that time we realize it, isn't it? We see the people are very skinny, you can see the bones, actually you can count the bones. But that time, you know, we realize, and that's the one happiness. The other happiness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I'm going to give you when you meet me for the fasting. So Allah will give us, inshallah. And the next thing here, even, you know, sip of water. You can break fast with dates or sip of water, but don't delay the time of breaking fast. As soon as sunset, you have to break the fast. Some people, they keep on making longer duas. It's not mustahab. Okay, our beloved Prophet, as soon as, you know, time comes, you break the fast. I'm not saying don't be hasty and do it before it. No. It's not so. Otherwise, you have to do the whole thing. And this reminds me of, like, you know, what if a woman, she is fasting and she feel like something wrong, and she check herself in the bathroom and she came to know period came. And only 10 minutes left for the, you know, breaking the fast. What happened? It's gone. And some says, no, after 11 o'clock, it's not, it's okay. No, it's not okay. What is the authentic narration? You know, if it breaks, that's it. Even though 5 minutes or 10 minutes before. Sometimes we are literally scared to go and check. Especially this last part of the thingy. Really, it's really make us nervous. No. It should come after. You know, once I break the fast and then it should come. But it happens, unfortunately. Not only sometimes we make up the fast. That time also, you know, almost it was end of the time and it came. And again, you have to make up. It happens, you know. So don't worry about that. And inshallah, you're going to break. And there is no such thing like, you know, breaking the fast with the salt. There is no such thing. That is maybe cultural. And invocation for the fast, you know, what is the dua for the fasting? Zahaba zamu wabtulat uruqi wasabbata ajuru, inshallah. This is the dua. The other dua, Allahumma laka samto, that is da'if. Okay, that is the if. And here, so we're going to recite this. If you don't remember, just, you know, keep it as a screenshot and make it, you know, in the phone. It's easy to remember it. Or you can keep it on the fridge, inshallah. And this is the month of Ghufran. What is the month of Ghufran means? Month of forgiveness. ask a lot of forgiveness. There are different duas of forgiveness. Inshallah, in the end, we'll discuss about it. In Surah Al-Najm, there's an ayah in that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who avoid the major sins, allazina yajtabiuna kabaira, major sins, if they avoid it, and immoralities, like, you know, fawahish, and only the ka, and then indeed your Lord is vast in forgiveness. So here, two things are given. Major sins we should avoid, and also the bad talk and bad scenes, everything we should avoid. Then only you're going to have forgiveness. And here, we keep on doing mistake, but remind yourself. And here, the best opportunity for ourselves to purify oneself. And this is like, you know, avoid all the things. We know our weakness. I know myself, you know, what I do. Maybe I get angry on somebody. Maybe I have a, you know, I know myself where I am lacking. So I have to improve myself. Nobody can tell me. And sometimes our dear ones, they tell you, it doesn't mean that, you know, they are criticizing it. They want you to improve. They want you to be good. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab, ayah number 35, men and women who observe Psalm fasting during the month of Ramadan and optional Nawafil fasting, Allah has prepared for them forgiveness and great reward. What is that great reward? That is paradise. That is Jannah. So one who finds Ramadan, he should ask, or she should ask forgiveness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, you know, keep on asking forgiveness in the Quran. And also our Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say astaghfar more than 70 times. So we are the ummah. Why don't we? You know, right now we are here, say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. With the intention, whatever the things we do it. You know, some culturally thing, we did, oh, toba, toba, you know, we did the mistake. That's how we used to do when we were kid, you know. Oh, toba, we did the mistake, Allah forgive us. Okay, that culturally, but actually understand what you did mistake. What if when we were like young and we didn't do salah? You know, we were in the school and we missed the salah. Ask forgiveness with complete shaur, realizing your mistake. What if you hurt someone? You know, do a lot of astaghfar. And time of suhoor, when you have the suhoor, that is the time, you know, astaghfar, lot of astaghfar you can do. And in Surah Al-Zariyat, the hours before dawn, they would ask forgiveness. In Surah Al-Zariyat, ayah number 18, it say, they will ask more and more yastaghfiruna, people will do in the last period of the dawn. So we should also ask astaghfar, lot of astaghfar we should do. So they are, you know, astaghfirullahul azim, allazi la ilaha illahu, al-hayyul qayyum wa tubil. Or just simple say astaghfirullah, you know, that also fine. And this is the month of taqwa. We have seen the ayah where it says this is the month of taqwa. So we want taqwa. So Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu says taqwa is what, you know, you are gathering your clothes and going from the thorny way, and you don't want any thorn to pierce your clothes, isn't it? So you are so careful about it. So we are so careful, like, you know, we don't want anyone to get angry, especially Hukuk Allah and Hukuk Libad. What are the difference between these two? Hukuk Allah, you know, what are the haq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We want to give the haq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Hukuk Ibad, you know, what are the haq of the slave? Or like, you know, what if you are hurting somebody and you are saying, no, I'm busy in my prayer, I'm busy in my reading the Quran, but you are bad to somebody. You know, Allah says for ibadah, it's between you and Allah. But what if you are hurting somebody, that person has to forgive you. So as we have mentioned, like, you know, this is a month of taqwa. So have that taqwa, you know, try to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is a training time, you know, make me steadfast. Ask ihdina sirat al-mustaqim, and lot of zikr you do. And also abstain from all the things which make you feel, you know, you get carried away. Everybody knows how they carried away. I can't tell you right now. And here, there's a dua, Allahumma inni asaluka al-huda wa tuha wa afafa wal ghina. Oh Allah, indeed, I ask you for the guidance, consciousness, chastity and contentment. This is in Sahih Muslim. You can, you know, recite beautiful duas. Duas has lot of effect on your life. But you have, it's just not right, you know, reading the dua and not even understanding it. Just you know, see the translation besides it, you would understand. Oh, what I am asking? Ask with the complete, you know, shaur. Oh, what I am asking? I am asking forgiveness. You know, even when we are doing salah, after completing, subhanallah, subhanallah. Do it, subhanallah, subhanallah. Do it nicely, you know. Even when we are driving also, do it very nicely, comfortably, you know. And this is a month of sabr. Do a lot of sabr. And you know, in Suratul Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are the people who do a lot of sabr. They are, you know, they gulp it down the anger. And kazimina ghis afina anin nas. And those are the people, those who are muhsinun. Muhsinun are who do ihsan on others. So sabr has a lot of significance, you know. And here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, mentioned in Quran also, but there's a hadith here. Fasting removes all the rancor of the heat, and it is narrated by Ibn Abbas. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, fasting is the month of patience and Ramadan. Fasting for 3 days each month removes the rancor of the heart. Means, you know what that 3 days? Ayyame Bid. 13, 14 and 15. And apart from that, you know, you are fasting in the month of Ramadan, that is removing the rust from your heart. And also, when you are fasting Monday and Thursday, make it a habit. It's like a training time, you know. And then you can pull yourself from the things which are not right. And here, let's see the ayahs of the Quran where Allah is saying how they are doing the sabr. And you know, indeed, I have rewarded them this day for their patience. They were doing sabaru, Suratul Muminun, ayah number 111, and they are the attainer of success. Faizun, they are the success, they are getting it. Because we have to do sabar. And Suratul Dahr, ayah number 12, it says, will reward them for what they patiently endured with the garden in paradise and silk garments. And we all love good garments and good clothes and good jewelry. So these are the ayahs, you know, motivate us. Oh, we want to do sabar, you know, Allah will reward in such a manner. And we can't compare clothes from here. Whatever we have, there's no comparison. So here we are doing sabr. We feel sometimes thirsty, sometimes we get angry, you know. Some scholar says, you know, angry, hungry, angry, isn't it? Sometimes because of the hunger we get angry. Well, especially, you know, when you are back from the college or school, and what is, like, you know, your empty stomach, and that time you behave very differently. You are not normal. Because I know, I did the same thing. I remember, so the kids, they do the same thing. I have seen the people everywhere, all the kids, whether here or anywhere in the world, that's how they behave. So why? Because they don't have that, you know, they want something to eat. But in a Ramadan time, they are calm, they are cool. When they are back, we see, oh, they are all right, they are doing good. But we are so concerned for them. Are you doing okay? Because they are not even eating properly. So girls, you have to eat properly, inshallah, have your suhoor properly, because it's a barakah. Even you can have water or few dates, you know, make it a habit. But that time you want to sleep. Oh, let me sleep sometime and then I can wake up and have it, you know. But once you get married, you get used to it. But this is the age you want to have nice sleep. And I notice, you know, this age, teenage period, that sleep is different from the, you know, after once you are enter into 30s or 40s. You don't have that sleep. Now you have sound sleep. If somebody push you, you won't wake up. That's how it's gonna be. So subhanallah. But you know, no matter what, you are doing for the sake of Allah. We want to please Allah subhanallah ta'ala. We are not to whom we are pleasing, to Allah subhanallah ta'ala. So here, let's see a few more things here. This is the month which is recitation of the Quran. Have you seen, like, you know, when Amira was reciting it, we are feeling so nice. Oh, we should recite the same way. MashaAllah, she is reciting. even makarij was good, and you know, the harakas was so good, and we feel, oh, because I know, like, the good recitation, because I have that feeling, you know, I want to recite good and good, you know. I go to so many tajweed teachers, you know. I love all the tajweed teachers. Believe me, I respect them so much, because the way they recited, they got that such a beautiful gift. And this reminds me of that hadith, you know, people who will recite the Quran, they will recite and ascend. And when we die in the grave, a person will be there, and who is very nice, and you know, and the, who he was, it's the Quran. There are two things that will intercede. One is Quran. And who will get intercede of the Quran? Oh, you're loving it and putting in the, you know, nice cover and putting in the shelf, or at the time of the wedding, you're putting on the head and, you know, you're passing by. No, no, no. You have to recite it. No matter, all the time. All my teachers, they always keep their mushaf. One of my tajweed teacher, she keeps so handy. She says, oh, You want to recite? Okay, go ahead. I said, you are in the parking lot, right? Isn't it? She says, so what? I can listen to you. I have my mushaf. I said, you are in wudu all the time. Subhanallah. And she says, okay, let me see how you recite it. So that's the inspiration for me. I said, no, no matter what, be in wudu, be ready every time to recite it. Or read it or recite it or listen it, or you know, if you have good you know, tajweed, you can make them learn both ways. Either you are a student or a teacher, both ways. So keep reciting it, because Quran gonna intercede you who reads it daily basis. It's not like once in a while, oh, this is so much dust now, I'm not reading from so many days. No, it's not so. You have to read. Now we got all the gadgets, right? Isn't it? Phone, iPad, whatnot. We can read it so easily. So be in wudu, keep your Quran mushaf handy and start reading it in like, you know, in the phone or iPad. But make a habit. If you are doing in mushaf, like, you know, in period, you're going to miss at least 8 to 10 days, depending on you. You make it a habit right now, you're going to do 30 pages. Do it from Usmani mushaf. So that, do more and more. If you are at work, try to do more at the time of suhoor and on the weekends, you know, in the evening time. Because I know it's hard when you go to work or when you go to school, it's hard. And one more thing which interested, it was the fasting. That's the mandatory fasting which we are doing it. So recite lot of Quran, and that is the thing we're going to do, inshallah. And if you know how to recite it well, then memorize it. If you can memorize it, at least, you know, 30th juz, last ayahs, or at least make it the intention, oh, I'm going to do Suratul Mulk. Ayah day, 30 ayahs, 30 days. What if 29 days? That's okay. Some ayahs are very small in that. Just make a habit, 30. So any surah, maybe smaller one or bigger one, make it a habit, oh, this Ramadan, I'm going to memorize it. So here in the Quran, we're going to do three things. First, the recitation, Nazre Quran. You're going to complete the whole Quran, depending how you can do it. And the second thing, you're going to listen or read the translation. Either listen or read the translation, however you want. So that when you come for Taraweeh, you know for sure which juz is going on, what Allah is talking about. And you know, you can concentrate more. Even if you are in period, doesn't matter. You come with your girls and have a time, because girls want to have chit-chat with their friends, and even we want to have the chit-chat with our friends. And then you can have this, but listen to the Taraweeh nicely. And make it a habit, like, you know, you can attend online. Any course, if Dore Quran is going on, you can listen to that, or you can come to masjid. Allah knows your intention, because you want to understand, you want to go through the whole Quran. And I think this is the best time, you know, we are getting opportunity to go from juz 1 to juz 30. Isn't it? It's so nice. Like, you know, those who are doing Quran course, they know when they read for the test, when they read for the assignment, they feel so happy. Oh, I'm going to go through the whole juz. Now I'm going to do the half juz. So make it a habit. All the three things, inshallah, we're going to do. And this is the month of dua. Do a lot of duas. Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry, one quick comment while you are still on that topic, because I'm going to forget in 10 minutes. during Ramadan, we have a blue flyer over there with all the three sheikhs over there. We have a visiting scholar coming. His kiras is supposed to be beautiful for Tarawih. So please participate in listening to him. And he will actually be doing tajweed classes for sisters on the weekend. Please look at that time. I fought for that time because they were trying to give an inconvenient time for the sisters, and they picked this time for the brothers. I'm like, this is a sister's time. If you want to do a different time for sisters, mm-hmm. do it for a different time. Again, if this time doesn't work for sisters, please let me know and we can pick a different time. But he's here. Alhamdulillah, his recitation is beautiful. So if you want to practice the tajweed, please make sure you're there. Otherwise, they will take that slot away.
Mm-hmm, inshallah. So here, make lot of duas, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, when my servant asks me about me, says I am very near, and Allah loves to answer the duas. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is very close, closer than jugular vein, very close. So make a list and ask more and more. And you know, you can start memorizing duas, or you can see the translation and read it. There are Quranic and Masnoon duas. You can download the app, but better to have the book, you know, inshallah. Or you can have Fortress of Muslim also, whatever way you want to. And do lot of zikr. Do the tasbih whenever you are going, wherever you are going, whenever you are in the period or any time when you are going and doing household work. Do a lot of zikr. Okay, make it a habit. And here, later on, we see after, you know, almost it's the completion of the month of Ramadan. And, you know, try to forgive people. Right now only think, okay, to whoever you hurt, you tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if possible, that person also, and make the matter clear. And later, here we see a few more things. This is the month of charity. Give lot of charity. And I see some people, they come to masjid and you know, they have habit of putting every time charity. That's really appreciating. You know, Allah loves that charity. And charity, sadaqa, it will remove the calamities. And Allah, you know, it will remove Allah's anger also. And also a lot of disease. So do a lot of charity. And here, I think it's going to be fundraising also. This month, I don't remember the date. In that also, we can participate and do that. And what about Qiyamul Layl? All the 10 days, you know, keep your 10 days exclusive. Whether you know, you're doing job, school, doesn't matter. Keep that 10 days. You think that's the appointment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm going to ask a lot of forgiveness because we don't know when is Laylatul Qadr. And we can't make so much prayer like 83 years. They calculate and says it's like 83 years you are doing ibadah. Can we do that right now if you are 30s or 40s? We can't do that, right? It's so hard. So make lot of zikr, and especially last 10 nights, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to wake up their family. So we going to do that, at least on the weekends, Friday night and Saturday night. And what if, you know, if you don't have work that much, you can take off. Especially for our men's and for the sisters, they usually take off in the last days. And itikaf. They can do itikaf 3 days, 1 day, or 10 days, depends. But when they go to itikaf, wife can go and give the food. But don't start chit-chatting, you know. Only the things which are allowed, I am saying. But for the necessity. It's not like, you know, and whoever is doing itikaf in the masjid, they have, you know, every time they prepare the things, and you have to tell them before, men's. I'm not sure about the women, because in last year, they had in ISG. And we used to do some of the women in the daytime, because in the nighttime it was hard. But I have seen some women, they were doing in the nighttime also. But this year, I am not sure. Inshallah, you can go on the website and look for it. So it's mustahab to do in the masjid. That's how our Ummahatul Mumineen did, our mothers of the believers, you know. That's how they did. And in the itikaf, no talk, you know, like whatever is necessary, that much talk. You can give the food and they can come and drop you. That's the thing. And here, after, you know, completing the Laylatul Qadr, we are asking forgiveness and making lot of zikr, lot of ibadah, everything. But what if, like, you know, one day before we are going and putting the, you know, henna, okay, it's good, but make lot of dua, because it's like going farewell, it's gone, it's saying goodbye to you. And we don't know, do you remember the people who were with us last year? They are not anymore. So do a lot of, you know, dua for that day, especially Ramadan is going. And after Ramadan, on Eid day, you have to, you know, when you wake up and take the shower, it's mustahab. And go from one way and come back from the other way. That is also a sunnah. And cover yourself properly. And even if you are in period, still you can go for the Eid prayer and you can listen and have good time. And also, after that, do your siyam for 6 days. What if you miss your period, and then so husband will be doing the siyam for the Shawwal and you will be doing your missed ones. And after that, once you are done with the missed one, then you can. But some people say, can we have the two niyas, this and that? No, one niya at a time. That's it. And this reminds me, for the fard, you know, siyam, you have to have niya. There is no such thing like reading it. It's in the intention. Niya is in the heart. So for the fard, and here, inshallah, we're going to end here. Just a quick review. So we start with the welcome Ramadan, and I recited about the Suratul Anfal ayahs, like, you know, how a believer should be when ayahs are going on, when ayahs are recited. Wajilat qulubuhum, our heart will fill with the awe. But, you know, not only that, even our iman is increasing, isn't it? And after that, we have seen the ayahs of the Ramadan. Allah is saying, this is the month you have to, ayyaman madudat, only few number days. And we're going to do a lot of dua, lot of charity, and we're going to forgive people, no matter what, how bad they are. We don't know how bad we are. We can't see ourselves, you know. So forgive the people for the sake of Allah. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to, you know, forgive us, inshallah. And keep the stuff, everything ready. Especially, you know, prepare yourself for Eid. What are the things you want to buy right now, even the grocery and everything, and do the charity, lot of charity, inshallah. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakallah khair, everyone. May Allah reward.